Hey, collective, it's your girl Mermaid Prophetess bringing you another collective reading. Let's see what's going on, my beautiful divine feminines, my beautiful divine masculines. Let's see what's going on. Okay, you guys, this is a pretty big deck, and I have pretty small hands. All right, so let's see what's going on here. We have, you don't have to feel the need to put somebody down to make yourself feel better. So this came out in reverse, okay? Alrighty. Now somebody's putting somebody down. Alright, let's see what else. I'm gonna snatch the card out of here. Let's see. Yeah, we have the Six of Wands. I love that. Talks about victory. Okay, so somebody feels the need to talk down on a divine feminine. Somebody feels the need to talk down on a divine feminine, even though it's like this person could have been, whoever they see as divine feminine, this is karmic energy. This person was looking towards your downfall, like forward to your downfall. Okay, this is somebody who felt like you weren't going to be winning, like you wouldn't survive something here. All right, so let's see. We have the Tower. Okay, come through, big Scorpio energy. I'm using my Nicki Minaj deck, you guys. Okay, so this person, whoever this karmic is, this karmic is in shock that you're winning, that you're still here, that your destiny is still for you. This is somebody that felt like they were going to be able to take that from you. All right, so let's see. Let's take one more from this deck. This deck is huge, you guys. All right, let's see. And we have the Three of Cups. Okay, I cannot. We got the High Priestess splitting the deck, strong Pisces energy, and we have forward movement. Okay, so I'll take this High Priestess energy. Ace of Wands underneath it. Okay, let's get this deck over here. Okay. Divine Feminine, this is like somebody who definitely put you down. This is karmic energy. This is someone that constantly spoke ill of you. This is this karmic energy here. This is a person that spoke very, very ill on you. This is a person who could have been manifesting your downfall. This person is shocked that you're here. You have something great coming towards you, Divine Feminine or Divine Masculine. Energy can be masculine or feminine. Please flip the roles as it makes sense for your situation. You're winning here. You have success in front of you, Divine Feminine. But there is a karmic energy. This could be more than one person. It takes more than one person to have a conversation. This is a lot of negative gossip around Divine Feminine. This person is shocked that you haven't been destroyed, that you're still here, and that you have blessings on the way. From some of you Divine Feminines, you have blessings coming in now. Ever since detaching yourself from a very toxic situation or a situation that felt like, I don't know why I feel like the Divine Feminines that I'm talking to today, you went against the grain here. But you have this, you got this. Six of Wands in the Tower, you shocked them. This is like a table will be set in front of your enemies where they will have to watch you eat, Divine Feminine, with the Three of Cups and the High Priestess here. Whoever this is, whoever these karmic energies are, Divine Feminine, these are karmics who felt like they knew for sure. These could be karmics that got a tarot reading on you with the High Priestess being here. These are karmics that felt like you were clueless. You could be a High Priestess, Divine Feminine. You could be highly intuitive. Somebody could have a strong Pisces placement, a strong Taurus placement. But this person, it's like whoever these karmics are, they're in shock. It's like they felt like what they like manifested for you. You wouldn't have anything to celebrate. These are people who prayed on your downfall, prayed for your destruction, and they're extremely disappointed. You're still here. You're still standing. You're still beautiful. You're still manifesting, and these people are shocked. I cannot. February 16th could be significant. January 6th, June 1st, June 12th, June 16th, June 2nd. All right, so let's see what else is going on here. Ooh. Look at that. Apothecary. Yeah, so there's an occultist here. Or somebody who is manifesting your downfall, or someone who, whoever these karmics are, these are people that felt like they could lead you to your destruction. These are people who would meet up with appointment being here to plot and scheme on you. These people could have group calls, group meetings, conference calls about Divine Feminine. There could be group stalking here. These are people meeting up, finding ways with this Tabao energy to bring very aggressive energy towards Divine Feminine or Divine Masculine. Let's see. Even with this Tabao energy, this is like, this is definitely a meeting, but this also, this card also says, makes my flesh tremble in their different greeting. So Divine Feminine, from the moment this person who was trying to manifest your downfall came into your presence, it's like from the moment they said hello, you knew that this person wasn't right. You knew that there was some kind of nasty energy coming from multiple karmic energies here. And this card even says, if that thy bent of love is honorable, the purpose of marriage, like, this is like a group of karmic energies that felt like you were in a divine union, Divine Feminine, that was going to lead to a marriage, or you could be married to Divine Masculine here. Whoever these karmics are that thought for sure, this is somebody who was plotting on your downfall. They thought for sure that they had this in the bag, that you would be crushed, you would be destroyed. These people laughed, these people gossiped, these people had conference calls about you, Divine Feminine. I mean, you're the topic of discussion. This was definitely about how Divine Masculine felt about you. We have Romeo energy, balcony of love, and fall in love. This is what these people would discuss. Somebody could be an alchemist here, or these people were master manipulators or something like that. It could also be somebody's very aggressive here, very aggressive energy. What else? Yeah, solitude. These people are like meeting in private. This is like, with this solitude energy showing up, some, I don't know why I feel like even looking at this, with this woman here in this big empty space, this is like Divine Feminine. Someone is very disappointed that you're still standing here. This is, for some of you Divine Feminine, somebody stole your identity, or they thought they would take your energy here, or that they would somehow forcefully destroy you. This is a group of people that meet up to destroy, that met up to destroy you. Masquerade ball here. Somebody was two-faced, three-faced. I don't know why I'm getting three-faced. Like, I have never said three-face ever in my life, okay? And for some reason, I'm saying that today. Somebody's playing in three people phase. Okay. We'll see what that occultist energy is, that apothecary energy is as well. Somebody's cunning here. A slick talker. Somebody could have tricked somebody into doing something very aggressive so this person could regret what they've done. Somebody broke out of this situation. One of these karmics could have gotten out of this situation because they felt like they went too far. We have rings here. And then we have this loyal energy here. We have this loyal, devoted energy here. There is, and I'm underneath this tower too, about to kind of cross up underneath this Three of Cups. However, this Divine Masculine is. This is a Divine Masculine who is sitting in shock. Solitude rings, tower. This masculine is, I don't know why I want to say the winning team, okay? So somebody might like Jocelyn Hernandez, get with the winning team. Okay, but it's solitude, tower, and rings. So this Divine Masculine, he could have isolated himself from these karmic energies. Something became way too aggressive when his masculine decided he had to get away from everyone here. And it's like, in this solitude, this masculine, it's like he's in deep thought here. He's keeping quiet. This masculine feels like somebody tried to persuade him. Or somebody is trying to persuade him with this pacifying energy. This card also talks about persuasion, with persuade being here. There could be a Scorpio here involved. I'm getting Gemini energy as well, Virgo energy, Capricorn. Definitely Capricorn. Capricorn, Aries. With this pacified energy, this is like, this masculine figured something out. That something was forced on him. Whoever this divine masculine is, he recognizes that somebody forced his direction, or tried to persuade him, or somebody's persuasion or reassurance was full of trickery here. This is a masculine that's separating himself from karmic situations here. He's detaching from karmics here. He recognizes the trickster is what I want to say. This card literally says, my poverty, but not my will, consents. Somebody could be a user here. There could be a group of karmic attachments here. These people got together and felt like you were going to destroy their plan or something like that, divine feminine. This masculine, it's like he separated himself from whoever these karmic attachments are. It's in solitude. There's a three-faced person here. I don't know why I'm getting three-faced. Okay. One of these karmic attachments is betraying the other karmics, but not because they feel guilty or how they feel about divine masculine. This has something to do with like an inner battle or something like that between the karmics. This person could have told this divine masculine that, this person could have told this divine masculine about whatever this trickery is, this aggression, these lies, this plot and scheme to persuade him. These people were acting under the consult of a dark priestess here. Could be getting tarot readings. Let's see. Yeah, misunderstanding. Okay. So this pacifier card also talks about persuasion, reassurance, clarifying, and identifying. And with misunderstanding and this aggressive energy, whoever this divine masculine is, he's recognizing that someone intentionally, these karmic attachments or a specific karmic, specifically confused him. And the way they confused him about something and somehow got his trust, because we're still talking about this pacify card, they were able to get his trust, and he believed them so much so that he actually kept quiet about what they persuaded him. Whatever they persuaded him about, it was about divine feminine. Because you have these people in shock, divine feminine. These people never. And when I say never, expected you to be in this energy. And even when I look at this card, this is like a moment where Nicki, in Nicki Minaj's video of No Frauds, where it's like she's clapping back. She made she made millions off of a diss track here. This is like, I don't write disses, I make hits. Divine Feminine, okay, you are literally empowering this No Frauds energy. I don't know, like, what lyric in the song that you need to hear, but maybe go read the lyrics, because it's like, Divine Feminine, somebody thought that you were down, okay? And when I think about this No Frauds energy, there was a mocked funeral given where several other artists tried to end her career. I don't know why this is coming to, I never had this come to me in a reading. And they expected her to be down and out. They expected her to be over with. They expected her career to be over with, her success, her longevity. But in actuality, ever since this, she's actually like the most peaking artist right now. So she's very successful, longevity, hitting new strides. So Divine Feminine, this is like somebody thought that you were done. They counted you out. They felt like they manifested enough against you with this time ball and this apothecary energy. They felt like you would be destroyed. And you surprised this person. Because you're powerful here, Divine Feminine. You're protected by the Most High God. You're in this High Priestess energy. You seen this nasty energy coming before it even hit. This Divine Masculine, he's the one that surprised. But whoever this three-faced karmic is, they alerted him. And now this Masculine is recognizing that whoever was the main karmic persuading him, they specifically didn't want him to communicate something. Somehow they convinced this Masculine to not be clear with you, Divine Feminine. You could have felt like this Masculine was holding something back. They convinced this Masculine to not be clear with you because they knew that you would see right through this. So they needed him to not say anything. They knew you were in this High Priestess energy. They knew that. Whoever this Masculine is, this Divine Masculine is daydreaming about being happy. Ooh, cards are like really messy. I don't know. This feels messy. Whoever these karmic attachments are, they are messy. And these people plotted on Divine Feminine so much so that they literally had meetings. I don't know why I'm getting like actual meetings to discuss Divine Feminine. This was plotting, scheming. These people, they were obsessed with this soul connection between you and this Divine Masculine. This Masculine feels played. Tell me about Apothecary, Tybalt, all of this gossip, praying for your downfall. What's going on here? Okay, we have this. We have the Hangman here, okay? Oh, I feel like I'm stumbling in my words here. The Hangman in reverse, it talks about being stagnant. It talks about fear. Somebody could be very afraid. Okay, Divine Feminine, whoever this group of karmics is that, whoever these groups of karmics are who attacked you, Divine Feminine, you are attacked here. Whether spiritually or through trying to manifest your downfall, this is definitely attack on Divine Feminine because the expectation was for you to lose in every area of life, especially when it comes to a soul connection, a divine union here. With the Hangman in reverse, this karmic attachment, this group of karmic attachments, especially this main dark energy here, somebody's a main karmic here. They were very certain that this would work against you. Very arrogant. Now this person is afraid. It's like some kind of sacrifice energy is surrounding this person now. This person is afraid. Very strong Pisces energy to open up the reading. This person is terrified. Yeah, whoever this is, this person tried to spiritually influence your life, Divine Feminine. This person tried to physically influence your life. There's a lot of aggression here. 3D energy, a lot of manipulation of energy, 5D energy. What else? Month of December could be significant here. What I say? We got the Five of Swords. These people were jealous. Jealous and gossiping about Divine Feminine. These people had very disturbing conversations about Divine Feminine. This could be up to five karmics on an actual phone call about Divine Feminine. Being very aggressive, disrespecting you like crazy. These people are very arrogant. These people are very jealous of you, Divine Feminine, but they could never beat you. Competing where they don't compare. Having all of these conversations, these people were manifesting. These people literally were having like group prayer sessions, but these are like dark prayers. These people were trying to manifest your downfall. This is why they're shocked. They are amazed that you're still here, Divine Feminine, that you still have blessings coming. I don't know why I'm thinking about so much Nicki Minaj energy. This is crazy. There's a line that she says in a song, I think it's her Super Freaky Girl song, Roman Mix, where she says, been in the game 15, ain't peak yet, ho. So I feel like Divine Feminine, the best of you has yet to come. You have big blessings here, Divine Feminine. You're wearing a crown. Like, you're amazing here. You're powerful here. You're strong. Look at that. Look at that. Strength card, Empress. Leo, your heart, you got a heart of gold, Divine Feminine. You're in this Empress energy. You're not chasing. You're attracting. You're attracting abundance. And you're walking away. You got your back turned to these. It's like, Divine Feminine, these people, they competing with themselves. You don't even see what's going on behind you. Okay? Like, you can't even see what's going on. Like, you don't know what's going on outside of the building. You know intuitively, but you're not giving them that physical energy, Divine Feminine, because you know that these people are jealous. You know that these people are jealous. These are your haters, and they're very aggressive. These people, strong Taurus energy, Libra, these people kept up a lot of drama surrounding your name, Divine Feminine. And now these people are pissed off that you're still standing. You're still winning here. You have something coming up for you, Divine Feminine, that you will be celebrating. Something shocking is coming in for you. And with rings under tower, this could be a proposal for some of you guys. For some of you guys, there's an engagement coming back on for those of you that want that. But you're celebrating here. Or this is new love that you're getting into. Whoever this dark high priestess is, this dark high priestess could also be the occultist. And this person, they don't understand. They're in shock how this aggressive energy didn't take you out. You could have had, especially with appointment and solitude, Divine Feminine, you could have kept having like life interruptions. And what that means, what I'm saying, Divine Feminine here, and excuse me, I'm kind of jumbled. Somebody's talking like at 100 miles per hour. Somebody's talking really fast here. Somebody could be a fast talker. Okay, let me calm down for a second. This person, this dark priestess, this occultist, this person, this main aggressive energy towards you, Divine Feminine, this person is extremely pissed off because this person felt like something was going to work. And now this person is losing their mind. They can't figure out why this isn't working. For some of you Divine Feminines, you have great news coming in, or you recently got really good news. Somebody wants to be loyal to you here, or you're getting into, for some of you guys, you're going to be celebrating an engagement here. And somebody thought that you would be down and out. This is like somebody went too far. This Divine Masculine is recognizing that this person went too far. He sees all the jealousy. Ooh, this reading is different. We have the Four of Swords and we have the Two of Pentacles at the bottom. These people expected you to be like put down, Divine Feminine, laid out, stuck. These people didn't ask for some of you Divine Feminines, you ended up healing from something here. Hold on, you guys. Try to back these up a little bit. Actually, let me just move my little twins and I'll put this over here. These people were confident that you would be sick, you'd be laid out here, Divine Feminine, you would be stuck. Somebody could have tried to block your throat chakra. Let's see what else. Somebody could have Aquarius or Libra and Jupiter, Aquarius and Venus. May 4th, April 5th, the numbers 45 or 54 could be significant. December 5th, December 4th, May 12th, April 12th. Let's see, what else? Ooh. Try to get this right. Okay, so we got the moon in reverse here. Strong Pisces, Cancer energy. Whoo, that water energy is coming in heavy. Okay, we have the Nine of Wands. And we have the Sun. Divine Feminine, okay. Six of Cups at the bottom. Strong Leo energy. Nine of Wands talks about being a wounded warrior, being injured or needing to heal or even being sickly. With the Four of Swords here, this person, okay, whoever this person is. This dark priestess here. Okay. This, whoever this aggressive karmic energy is, this person that thought they won, they thought that they got you out the way, they didn't realize that you were doing you. You were building you up. That's what you were doing. You were in solitude to build you, Divine Feminine. Strong Virgo over there. They thought that you were defeated here, Divine Feminine. Somebody could be gang stalking you, stalking your social media, or just asking a lot of mutuals, people that know of you, about you. Somebody's trying to discover information about you. Cancer energy is here as well. Somebody can have Pisces in Neptune, Sagittarius in Neptune. Somebody could have a Sagittarius moon, Leo sun, Sagittarius sun. These people expected you to be sickly and ill and down. And yet here you are, Divine Feminine, fully healed. Four of Swords and the Sun, you can't be stopped. But whoever this person is, and this Hangman in reverse energy, underneath this apothecary, and because remember, all of this is up underneath these people who decided to try to take you down, put you down, destroy a divine union. There's some fear going on here. There's some in, didn't I say there was infighting? I was picking that up since the first deck. Five of Swords talks about infighting, talks about infighting as well. And aggression, a lot of aggression, intimidation. Okay, so we have a group of karmics falling out with each other, exposing one another. Moon in reverse, the sun upright, they're exposing one another here. There could actually be a physical altercation between karmic energies. And in the midst of this, somebody turned three-phase. Okay. Now I know. 27 on the clock as this, like right when this hit me. There is a karmic, these karmic attachments, this group of karmics, they're falling out with each other. These are people who went against Divine Feminine and Divine Masculine. These are people who misled, manipulated, or gaslit. Let me use the right word here. Okay, they gaslit a divine masculine here. Somebody was able to manipulate him based off of the loyalty that he has for this person. There could be a mother involved or a sister. Definitely karmic male friends, for sure. Too many masculine energies here at 1, 2, 3, 4. Somebody's kind of, I don't know, like somebody's kind of on both sides of the fence here. So there could be somebody, you know, with an alternative lifestyle here or something like that. Somebody could be a swinger or something. Okay. These people got together and it's like there's fallouts within these people, between these people. One of these karmics is playing in two other karmic's faces, at least playing in these two karmic faces and exposing them to this divine masculine as to why he had to keep quiet about something another one of these karmic attachments told him about divine feminine. Somebody felt like they was bringing this divine masculine to scoop something serious about divine feminine, as if this was something very major about Divine Feminine. And this masculine, it's like he feels extremely ghastly, but he doesn't trust this person, this three-faced person, because they're all exposing each other here. And there are multiple karmics here that are panicking. These people are afraid. There's some kind of sacrificial energy here where it could have been this union they were trying to sacrifice. Somebody could have been trying to sacrifice you, Divine Feminine. Somebody could have been trying to sacrifice this Divine Masculine. But this person is afraid because they are stuck with this energy around them. And it's like one by one, they're all getting hit. They're arguing with each other, fighting with each other, double on the aggressive energy. There could be a physical altercation between karmics here. Healing, hurt. They're like, there's multiple people here that's going through physical loss. And they're definitely being exposed here. This Divine Masculine is gaining clarity about something that happened in the past with the Six of Cups here. He can want reunion. This Masculine wants to drop these burdens with the Ten of Wands in reverse. Whew, this reading is different. I felt like it was going to be different. All right, so let's see. What else? What's going on? We got the Six of Wands up top. We got disappointment energy, the solitude. So y'all, groups of karmics meeting up with each other, having Zoom meetings, Divine Feminine. Imagine that. Google group calls, three-way calls, group WhatsApp messages, all about you. And the last message that they had, Divine Feminine, these people are pissed off that you are still standing. These people could have, especially whoever this reader is, or if somebody had a dream here and misunderstood the dream, and now what they thought was coming after Divine Feminine, they know it's coming after them. You're protected. You got this Temperance energy. We have the Page of Pentacles, the King of Wands, and the King of Swords. I'll tell you that there are several masculine karmic energies here, Divine Feminine. There is a Divine Masculine that wants to send Divine Feminine a message here. There's a karmic masculine that is completely against this. For some of you Divine Feminines, it's like this Divine Masculine wanted to send a message to you, and this karmic masculine, it's like he somehow blocked this. Somebody could be getting a letter from the court system here or something like that. It could be some kind of legal separation happening here as well. One of these masculines could be a fire or an air sign. Okay. For some of you Divine Feminines, this Divine Masculine is attached to two other masculines that they're attracted to you. They're attracted to what they've heard about you. Somebody's very upset here because they're hurt that you're winning, that you're still standing, that you're still here. Somebody could want to protect you here, Divine Feminine. There is definitely a masculine that wants to reach out to you with this Ace of Swords. I'm sorry, Ace of Swords. Whew. Ace of Wands, and this Eight of Wands. It's like something is changing here very quickly. Somebody, this masculine could want to speak the truth to you. There are multiple masculines that's a part of all of this gossip, all this jealous gossip about Divine Feminine. Let's see. Yeah, throat chakra blockage. Didn't I say Divine Feminine, somebody wanted to block your throat chakra? Okay, it's an undelivered message here. We have throat chakra blockage underneath this Page of Pentacles energy. Okay, so Divine Feminine, one of these karmic masculines or karmic feminines receive some kind, it's like this masculine could have trusted them like some kind of loyal friend here with this Mercutio energy, trying to send you some kind of message or something like that. And this person didn't give this message. Yeah, this person could have said, look at this. Ace of Swords, Queen of Swords, and the Nine of Pentacles. This person told this masculine, okay, either this is just a flat out lie, and somebody said that you said something that you never said, or this Divine Masculine asked somebody to give you a message, one of these karmic masculines that he trusted, and they said that your response was that you didn't want anything to do with this masculine, your guards are up, you're single. You know what I just got, Divine Feminine? Look at that. Didn't I say some kind of communication was blocked? Seven of Wands, Ace of Swords, Four of Wands. Some kind of communication was blocked, distorted, lied about. There's a block in a communication here too, that had major effects on a union here. For some of you Divine Feminines, something is being exposed here. There are lies being exposed here about you telling another masculine, for some of you guys, especially with this appointment energy. Like, somebody lied and said that you met somebody in private and that this person was trying to talk to you and you told them that you were single. This is while you're attached to this divine masculine. For some of you guys, that's a karmic on your side of the family that said this, whether they're masculine or feminine. There is definitely blocked communication here. And this was strategic. This masculine is realizing that he was gaslit so that he would block and sabotage his own union. The Four of Wands, Three of Pentacles. Yeah, these people work together. I cannot. These people are ridiculous. Give me a second. Let me get these last two cards so we can go over everything here. Yeah, we have the Death card. Strong Scorpio energy. Somebody could be... This is backfiring. Whoever these karmic attachments are that's sitting here gossiping, lying about Divine Feminine, plotting on your downfall, everything is backfiring on them. Seven of Swords, Three of Pentacles, Death energy. Now that the truth is exposed, this Divine Masculine has ended this immediately. Ace of Swords with the Death card underneath it. Now, this is done. This is adios. He's very defensive against these people. This Divine Master could be standing up. He knows the whole plan now. He knows what they were working on. Eight of Pentacles, Two of Wands. He knows what they were doing. As it pertains to all of it, this man, especially with the Seven of Wands, the Ace of Swords, and the Four of Wands, underneath this confusion energy, ineffective communication, and why they wanted this masculine to keep quiet about it. It's like if this divine masculine would have actually told you, divine feminine, about some of these lies, about what these people presented to him. They knew that there was something that would blow this up, that you would be able to prove that these were lies immediately. So they had to convince him to keep quiet. And now he knows that. With the truth being here, Ace of Swords underneath this pacify energy, he knows why. Misunderstanding, Four of Wands, this masculine feels like he was confused, that he was gaslit. Now all of this karmic energy is coming to an end. He knows that these people were working together. They were determined. One more. And the Knight of Wands and the Six of Pentacles. For some of you, Divine Fan, we're underneath this confusion energy, this misunderstanding. Somebody act like they knew something here. This is like Divine Feminine. Somebody tried to gaslight this masculine about you being in this lustful energy outside of your union with this masculine. You being in this Knight of Wands energy. You sleeping with people that you used to deal with. For some of you, Divine Feminine, somebody accused you of having a relationship with somebody you worked with or something like that. Are you still dealing with somebody that you worked with? I don't know why that energy has been coming up a lot lately too. For some of you guys, they're saying you did this for money. Somebody could be a prostitute here or something like that. Okay, we have September 19, September 18, January 8, January 9th, September 3rd, 13, March 9th, March 13, March 19th. I'm gonna take one more on that Knight of Wands energy. Knight of Swords. We have the Knight of Swords and we have the Judgment. Okay, so this is like, and this is underneath the High Priestess as well. So this person came in, Scorpio Sagittarius energy on the Judgment at the bottom. Whoever this karmic attachment is that came in and said something about Divine Feminine's disloyalty, some kind of major lie here. This person misrepresented the truth or blocked a message here, lied about something here. This person my God, I just got. For some of you guys, there's a karmic masculine who lied on Divine Feminine. This person actually said that they confronted another lover, somebody you were dealing with outside of this Divine Masculine, for him. That they came rushing in and defended this masculine by checking you, Divine Feminine. Or they said that they met up with this masculine after you. This is a person who said that they came in and stood up for this Divine Masculine. For some of you Divine Feminines, this is a person that you warned this Divine Masculine about. And they told this Divine Masculine that there's no reason for him to mention this to you because you don't like them. So you're going to deny this anyway. So it's like they convinced him. This masculine feels like he was gaslit into making a judgment call that ultimately led to him being extremely unhappy and feeling very much so manipulated. And whoever these karmic energies are, they are very pissed off that they now have to deal with all of this manifestation that they did against Divine Feminine. This reading is different. All right, so let's see what else is going on here. Sheesh. I cannot. That was a lot. Okay, we already 40 minutes in. I still feel like there's so much to talk about here. Okay, let's see. Tell me more about this aggressive energy. Somebody could be a narcissist here. Somebody's violent. Somebody could have a criminal past. We have responsibilities and talking. Yeah, these people are definitely talking about you, Divine Feminine. They could be talking about you not being able to take care of yourself. For some of you Divine Feminists, these people were talking about somehow making it so that you're unable to take care of yourself. Mentally, physically, financially. Somebody wanted you to, I don't know why I'm getting like anxiety attacks. Somebody could have wanted you to lose your mind, where you needed a lot of mental health help. Somebody wanted you in depression. Wanted you depleted here. It's like they tried to manifest for you to not love yourself. These people were very much so jealous of you sitting so high in your confidence, Divine Feminine. You could be an earth angel. Didn't I say they were talking about your abundance? We have abundance. Yeah, they were talking about how can we get rid of Divine Feminine's abundance? How could we make Divine Feminine sick? We want her to be sick. How do we manifest this? Somebody consulted a dark priestess here. And all of these people are in shock, Divine Feminine, because you're highly protected and blessed. You're wearing a crown, Divine Feminine. What I say? These people are having conversations about being unsatisfied. They're unsatisfied with the results of whatever this work is that they did against the Divine Feminine. Now these people are meeting up on the phone because they weren't able to impact you. Okay? We have Phoenix in reverse. Transformation in reverse. They're not satisfied because nothing changed. The only thing that's changing is that you're being rewarded. You have more blessings coming in. What they did to you. We have not enough chemistry. What they did to you, Divine Feminine. First of all, it wasn't enough and it was never going to be enough. And now these people are afraid. Especially whoever this, there's an occultist here. I have the High Priestess and the Apothecary card here. They're afraid. I don't know why I'm looking. I've seen this card many times, but I've never thought about blood magic here. There's some kind of blood magic here. It's kind of sacrificial energy here. It's kind of sacrifice. When it's not enough and all this blood on her mouth here, somebody's dark. This person is in fear. Yeah, these people got cut out. We got cut down, cutting out separation. Stop the pattern. This Divine Masculine has isolated himself from these people. These people are afraid. And on top of that, there are illnesses manifesting on these people. They tried to cut you down, but now they're being cut down here. With dishonesty in reverse, these lies have been exposed. And now this masculine is just done with this. This masculine can't believe this, that he allowed himself. I don't know why I just heard play it like a sucker. Why am I getting sucker? Why am I thinking about all these random things? I don't know why I just thought about that movie, White Man Can't Jump. Okay. I usually don't have this, like, this in movies, music coming in for me, but for some reason that's coming in. On that movie, if you guys remember that old movie, White Man Can't Jump, get his name, him and Wesley Snipes, they were able to take advantage of a lot of other ball players because nobody expected the white man to be able to jump. Okay, that's why it's called, well, I think the movie is literally called White Man Can't Jump. Divine Feminine, these karmics didn't expect you to jump. They didn't expect you to protect yourself. They didn't expect the archangels to activate for you. They didn't expect you to be so protected. They didn't expect you to move forward, to take a leap of faith, to get into that full energy and serve yourself and go on a journey and know that you are okay at the end. They didn't expect that. These people expected your destruction. And now these people are pissed off and they're in fear because all this destructive energy is stuck with them. I have the runner and I have confusion in reverse. I don't know why I'm getting, somebody's running here. Somebody could be running from the police here, from the police. For some of you Divine Feminine, somebody lied on some legal documents. I have the King of Swords and the Queen of Swords here. Divine Feminine, of these group of haters, because these are your haters, okay? And these are Divine Masculine haters as well. Somebody could be running from a warrant. Like, there's a warrant for someone's arrest here. Let's see what else. We have a mistake in reverse. Yeah, no mistakes here. They knew exactly what they were doing, and now they have to pay the cost. Something about the intentions weren't right here. Now they gotta pay the cost, and they're afraid. Try to take Divine Feminine's abundance. Now they're losing abundance. These people are very weak, broken, healing, multiple illnesses manifesting within them over and over and over. Some of these people can't even get sleep. They're up all night on guard, dark, shadowy figures. Okay, people being injured around them. Somebody could be dealing with a recent injury here. Tried to send all this energy to you, and for some of you Divine Feminines, this energy sat you down for a little moment just to put you in thought, for you to continue to, for you to think about. I feel like Divine Feminine, something knocked you off your square here, and it could have been this detachment from this Divine Masculine, and that knocked you off your square here, and that while you were grieving this divine union, somebody mistook. Okay. Whew, this is coming in. Okay, child, I cannot. Somebody mistook, whoever this karmic priestess is, mistook you grieving this union as what they manifested, this group of karmics against you, as coming true. And now these people are in shock, especially this karmic priestess. And they're in shock because they're realizing that they have to battle these their own energies. And now this energy of sacrifice, this energy of pain, this energy of loss is now consuming this group of karmics, these group of dark energies that tried to manifest your destruction here, Divine Feminine, all because of a union. Because they don't, and for some, they don't want you to have anything. And now they're dealing with it. Somebody's trying to run from their own karma. I have the runner. I have dishonesty. And I have escape. Trying to run from their own karma. And this is not working. Seven of Wands up over here. Yeah, this is like something that went back on them. They didn't expect for you to be so protected. And this Divine Masculine, they didn't expect him to begin to protect, to want to protect himself. Especially after knowing the truth, they didn't expect him to want to escape. They didn't expect him to cut them off, to isolate himself after learning the truth. These people are afraid of their own energies that they manifested. I've now seen self-indulgence twice. Okay? I've now seen this twice. And we have this coffin energy. These karmic attachments, they thought for sure that this coffin energy was to bring divine feminine endings, and you being able to communicate. You could have your career or business, you being able to articulate yourself, you being able to communicate and speak the things that you're intuitively picking up. For some of you, divine feminine, speaking is your power. Okay, these people wanted to take that away from you, your throat chakra. You may be an excellent prayer, like a prayer warrior, or the way you manifest has a lot to do with speaking, divine feminine. These people didn't want you to be able to manifest. These people didn't want you to be able to pray. They didn't want you to have abundance in any area of your life. Nine of Wands talks about health, Four of Swords, health. No abundance in health. They didn't want you to receive any blessings. No abundance in your physical safety, protection. And now these people are pissed off because they're dealing with this endings energy and they're trying to escape it. We have escape, we have coffin, we have self-indulgence. These karmic energies, they did it so much. It's so aggressive. This forced sin, this divine masculine feels like there was a forceful energy against him, against this divine union. You could have told him this. He could have kept quiet. He could have had that conversation with another karmic attachment here, not knowing he was speaking to the enemy. He could have told this masculine he needed to cleanse his energy. Woo. That came out strange. We have self-love. This is over here with this Ace of Wands. I'm sorry, Ace of Swords. I keep getting Ace of Wands. This masculine wants to take action. Let's see what else. We have the Chaser. This is in reverse. This is a masculine. Now that he's cut off these karmic attachments with the Chaser in reverse, that's giving me Eight of Cups energy. This is a masculine that he definitely wants to have a conversation with divine feminine, and you could feel that. We have Inseparable in reverse. Soulmates and guilty. When inseparable in reverse, this talks about separation. This masculine is realizing with guilty. Look at that, I can't make this up. Guilty and forgiveness. This masculine feels guilty for causing an ending with divine feminine. He feels guilty about it. He feels like it was his fault. He feels like he believed this ridiculous information that came in from whoever this karmic masculine is in this Knight of Swords energy. Or that could be a karmic feminine who's just in masculine energy. And like I said, there of all of these karmics, two of them are married to each other. All right, so let's see what else is going on here. My God, let's see. This reading probably is going to be so long. It's like opening up. The energy was so different. All right, let's see. Cards hitting me in the face. Child, this is ridiculous. Look, I'm over here doing clarifying back over this apothecary, this occultist energy. And we have the Queen of Wands. And she hit me right in the face, child. I cannot. Karmic energy. This could be a karmic lover. She could be a fire sign, have a strong fire placement. Whoever this dark occultist is, she might be an Aries or have a strong Aries placement. She could have done some kind of, this is a karmic hierophant energy, strong Taurus placement, strong Taurus energy. And then we have the Ace of Swords. These karmics are afraid because they know the truth is out. They know this masculine knows the truth. I've been picking up on that cult energy for a minute, still picking it up. There's a very aggressive group of people with very similar ideology. At least one person here was intentionally gaslighting this masculine in a very strategic, harsh way. Because they convinced him to keep quiet about something here. And now these people are in fear because the truth is out. For some of you divine feminines, whatever this karmic attachment, this karmic lover was mixing up, this has something to do with trying to get this masculine to be attracted to her energy. This could be your impersonator. This is somebody who she was doing everything that she did because she wanted this masculine to commit to her. And this blew up in her face. Tower and the Rings. Come on. This blew up in her face. We have the Strength card. Whatever this dark manifestations that they were doing over you, Divine Feminine, they were very strong-willed and determined. For some of you Divine Feminines, I don't know, I feel like some of you Divine Feminines, you can have people in your own family that's doing work on you, or your family has been a part of maybe like a multi-generational spiritual war, or this Divine Masculine's family could have a multi-generational spiritual warfare. So you could be putting off, somebody could be a generational curse breaker. This karmic lover was determined to control this divine masculine, control his heart, control his loyalty. She was going to force this marriage if her life depended on it. Now she's dealing with this coffin energy, so maybe it does. Yeah, she wanted to control him. Come through, spirit. Four of Pentacles talks about control. Strong Capricorn energy. This is somebody who didn't want to let go. So this could be a karmic ex that this masculine detached from. With this Five of Pentacles energy. More Taurus energy. Yeah, come through. Seven of Swords. Four of Swords. And then we have this Queen of Pentacles and this Magician energy at the bottom. Aquarius, Libra, Capricorn. Again. Jupiter and Aquarius Moon energy. This person, we have the Five of Swords here and we have the Seven of Swords here. Whoever this karmic lover is, she was determined to control this situation, control this masculine. She was in this aggressive energy. She had a group of divine feminine haters that was on par with her. These people were very much so involved, just as much as she was, okay? Very determined. She came up with an entire strategy to try to get this masculine back. This masculine left this karmic attachment out in the cold before. She regrets sending this aggressive energy to Divine Feminine with the Five of Pentacles here. Because now she has to deal with it. These people have fallen out with each other. And whoever this karmic lover is, she is very close with whoever this Queen of Pentacles is, who is directly attached to this Divine Masculine. This is somebody that whoever this Queen of Pentacles is, this is somebody that this masculine trusts. She doesn't have to be an earth sign, but she definitely could be, have a strong earth placement. Yeah, this masculine thought that this was somebody who wanted him to have a higher level of consciousness, right? We have Four Swords twice here. Like this masculine could keep his guards down around this person and that he would be wide open for this Seven of Swords energy. For this Magician energy. But we have Justice here. You want to talk about Karma, Libra energy, Gemini energy with this Magician showing up. Aries. We're going to come and see what this Seven of Swords is about. Let me get one more card for the Seven of Swords. Seven of Swords, please. What's this deception? This came out sideways. We have Eight of Cups. Coming out sideways. On the Four of Swords. Okay. Page of Cups here. Somebody wanted this Divine Masculine to feel like you had one foot in, one foot out. This was part of the lies, the strategy. It was like the strategy, whoever this, I don't know why, I just heard open door. Whoever this karmic feminine is, who's friends, I feel like this person is friends with a karmic lover. The plan was to get this karmic lover a foot in the door, a foot back in the door, when this masculine started to isolate, when this masculine left this karmic lover in this Five of Pentacles energy to help. This was all a part of gaining control. Strong Pisces again. And they were going to do whatever it took, whatever it takes. All right, take me over here. What we got? These people meeting up. Solitude. Divine Feminine. You winning. Somebody wanted to destroy a soul connection here. Let's see. Ace of Cups. You're winning. This is up underneath this Six of Wands energy, Divine Feminine. For some of you Divine Feminines, you have a whole new relationship coming in. This could even be marriage. Six of Wands. Ace of Cups. Four of Wands. This could even be marriage. Yeah, look at that. Justice? For some of you Divine Feminines, you're getting married. Or proposals coming in. Either from a reunion with this Divine Masculine or from a new love altogether. These people are salty. I feel like for a lot of you, this could be, they are salty about a reunion that leads to marriage very quickly. And even for some of you, this is them being salty about you moving on, having new love. You could be purchasing a new home here. You could be having a very extravagant marriage here. I got the Eight of Pentacles at the bottom. Some of you guys have a dream marriage. For some of you guys, this is a remote marriage in a foreign land somewhere. The solitude being here, very private. But for some of you guys, it's very public. This could be a private getaway marriage with a small group of people that a lot of pictures go up on your social media, Divine Feminine. I don't know why I'm getting all these details. But for some of you guys, this is just a big marriage. Big things happening. Celebrating buying a home. For some of you Divine Feminines, you have a court case, a lawsuit that you'll be winning here. Just looking beautiful here. Let's see. These people are mad. They expected this to not happen. Yeah, look at this. Four of Cups and the Ten of Cups. Part of what these people were manifesting for you, Divine Feminine, was for you to be rejected and for you to stay in this rejection energy. They were jealous. These people continuously compared themselves to you. These people created conflict in this union between you and this Divine Masculine. These people never wanted you to have the Ten of Cups. They only wanted you to dream of the Ten of Cups, but never have the Ten of Cups. This masculine is sad. This masculine is rejecting his karmic friends. If he hangs out with them a lot, it's like this masculine does not want to go out. He don't want to leave the house. He don't want to go out. He's thinking about Divine Feminine's pure love here and how he was gaslit because he wants the Ten of Cups. Cancer, Pisces energy here. Yeah, look at that. Two of Swords. Yeah, Two of Swords talks about avoidance. This masculine is avoiding karmic attachments here. They don't know why. For some of you guys, okay, because energy can be past, present, or future. So you guys could be anywhere in this timeline. 104.04. When I say that, I don't know how long this reading is going to be, child. They wanted to block this union, but now this Divine Masculine is blocking them. With this world card, this masculine has discovered what was actually going on here. Let's see. We have the Seven of Pentacles. Okay, so something was going on for a very long time. Come through Spirit, Page of Swords. So this Divine Masculine was being gaslit for a very long time. This gossip about Divine Feminine was going on for a very long time. These were your haters, Divine Feminine, for a good while. This masculine feels guilty. We have guilty forgiveness here. Don't forget. Soulmate guilty and forgiveness. Feels guilty for not telling you about all of the nonsense these people were coming and telling him. And now this masculine with the World card and the King of Swords, this masculine feels like he needs to close this cycle, especially with whoever this diabolical King of Swords is. Cause this king, he's here too. He's over here. He's right over here. This I feel like whoever this karmic masculine in this King of Swords energy, this is the same person that was in this Knight of Swords energy. This is also the same King of Swords that's up underneath the Tower and Rings. This is somebody this masculine thought he could trust. This masculine didn't realize that he was dealing with a cold-blooded person that only wanted to block a divine union or a twin flame connection. This masculine is closing this cycle out. And whoever this karmic masculine is, he's married. And his attachment, his wife, she's jealous of you too, divine feminine. You were too happy here. You, for some of you, you've never even met this woman. Just hearing about you was too much. Okay, I know why I just got this. Whoever this karmic masculine is that kept running their mouth, lying about divine feminine, claiming that they confronted somebody, this is ridiculous. Okay, that could resonate with some of you. Their wife is very miserable with them. And that's why she got hyper-focused on divine feminine. He could be attracted to you, divine feminine, because this person is obsessed with you. You and this masculine, together, you guys could have been like some kind of power couple or something like that. Let's see. Somebody running from the police? Somebody could have defrauded someone about a home or something like that, out of a home. Definitely gossiping about divine feminine. Empress energy is here. This has been going on for a long time, Taurus Libra energy. High Priestess, this was going on in secret. Okay, divine feminine, intuitively, you knew this. The Empress, the High Priestess, baby. Divine feminine, you are everything. You could be an empath here. You could have been pregnant here. Some of you divine feminines, there's a karmic attachment who had a pregnancy where the months didn't add up. The baby came in 7 months instead of almost 10 or something like that. Secrets about that being exposed. These people lied. For some of you divine feminines who's pregnant from your divine masculine, these people are talking about this child doesn't belong to him. And they are just doing this out of pure jealousy. For many of you divine feminines, this is just you knew about this gossip, about this bad mouth, and intuitively you picked this up. Sometimes this masculine would come towards you with the energy that just didn't make any sense. And he had just gotten gaslit about you. I could barely get my words out. Somebody stutters here. Yeah, look at that. The Emperor. This is over here. By soulmates, guilty and forgiveness. I have the Emperor, the Empress, and the High Priestess. And you want to talk about sadness, regret? He feels like a fool. He feels like he didn't express himself. He feels like this misunderstanding would have never happened had he not been in this pacified energy. He should have communicated. What I said, he regrets. Eight of Wands talks about communication. He regrets not communicating with you. Had this masculine communicated all of this in real time with Divine Feminine, there would have been no confusion. Because some of these lies that these people were telling on Divine Feminine, this Three of Pentacles, these people that wanted to create this tower, Scorpio energy, Three of Pentacles, cards are repeating itself like crazy. Knight of Wands again, repeating itself. You would have blown these lies up immediately. Immediately. But this masculine didn't even give you the opportunity to do that, because this masculine never came forward and actually communicated these issues with Divine Feminine. So now we're here. Oh my goodness. All right, let's see what else. Y'all, hold on. Okay, I know this reading kind of format is a little different, but we're gonna get through it. Yeah, this masculine, he wants forgiveness. He's in regret. He's embarrassed. And these people are falling out with each other, exposing each other. Truth is out now. Somebody could, they literally, there's at least two masculines here who got into some kind of shoving match or something like that. A karmic lover did everything she could with the help. This karmic lover had someone's help who's similar in age to her. I don't know why I just got that. So that could be a karmic sister, or a that could even be this feel like that's a different person. She could be married too, or divorced. They needed to get this mask. She needed a foot in the door. Let's see if we can get more information, and then I'm gonna get ready to go to the extended reading, you guys. If you haven't already, please make sure you like the video, okay? Make sure you're subscribed as well. In the extended reading, I'll go deeper into this read. That's so much. I'll go deeper into this reading. Okay, we'll see what the final outcome is. We'll see what this Divine Masculine's next moves are, because I definitely see some kind of communication coming to Divine Feminine here. So we'll see about that as well. Somebody's afraid of this coffee energy, because there's like illnesses manifesting around them. What'd I say? I have an ex-lover. Come through, spirit, with the confirmation. We have an ex-lover that was obsessed with Divine Feminine, a karmic ex-lover. Somebody could be breaking pictures, breaking glass. Mystery. Like, listen. This ex-lover could not get past this Divine Masculine. Unfinished business. She was obsessed. She wanted to get back with him. Unfinished business and bandages. She was going to patch this union back with this Divine Masculine together, even if she had to play on the side and set all this manipulation, trickery, spell work in motion. She was going to do that. She was desperate, determined, very aggressive energy, overly doing things, sent so much sacrifice and confident energy, trying to end your abundance, all of these endings energy. She knew exactly what she was doing. Did this in secret, created a lot of confusion with the help of another karmic attachment. This mystery card talks about confusion. Somebody, she could be a witch or something like that, or she consulted one. Halloween could be significant here. Something could happen in the month of October. Month of October could be significant. Divine Feminine, like I said, you had a gut feeling. You knew, and you were right. You could have exposed this person. You could have exposed. There is karmic family and friends here, Divine Feminine, that you could have exposed. Let's see. Ooh. Yeah. What I said, this karmic could not get over. This karmic ex-lover could not get over with heartbreak and breakup. This Divine Masculine, she was going to get in one way or another. Even if it kills her. And with all this sacrificial energy, the ones that were doing coffin spells, they know it's they know that this is bad for them. But Divine Feminine, you also knew that this breakup for some of you Divine Feminines was unnatural. And that broke your heart. And that's why you could have been in this grieving energy where you just grieved your union and healed. Some of you just said, you know what? Next lifetime. I'm not going to sit here and go through this. I'm not going to allow you to have me in this Four of Cups energy. As I came to you with pure intentions, you haven't done the shadow work to get all of these karmic attachments off of you. This woman got a whole, I got the altar card here. Whoever this karmic attachment is, she got a whole altar in her house. Meanwhile, you and this masculine, this is where you guys were going to be. We had a proposal, the altar, and sailing ship. Like I said, for some of you Divine Feminines, you guys either already discussed your honeymoon, or you're going to have a destination marriage or something like that. For some of you Divine Feminine, with this new love coming in, this looks like a marriage. Ace of Cups, Four of Wands, and the Justice. And the Ten of Cups is here as well. For some of you Divine Feminines, this destination wedding, this is coming with this new love or this reunion. We have no sorries allowed. This karmic attachment, yeah. We have divine timing. And we have this player energy, which is karmic energy. Okay? This Divine Timing card talks about karma. Karma is here. Definitely giving me Wheel of Fortune energy as well. Sagittarius, Jupiter energy. Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius energy. You knew the time would come where everything that these people were doing was going to hit them where it hurts. Everywhere where they wanted you to hurt, which is all of your abundance. Abundance in your spiritual protection, abundance in your connection with the Most High, with Source, abundance in health, abundance in wealth. They wanted everything that they manifested, this coffin energy that they put on your entire, all levels of abundance. All of this is back. With no sorries allowed, these people are trying to dodge this energy. They are begging and pleading. They are praying. Somebody could have just started going back to church. They don't want to be held accountable for this. They're falling out with each other. Somebody said that it's like, I don't know why I'm getting like somebody said they didn't know that this could happen, or somebody didn't tell them that this could happen. Look at this. We have guilty is charged. That's how somebody could be have a warrant out for their arrest. Let's see what else. Ancestors. Look, we have ancestors and free to go. Divine Feminine, your angels, the Most High God came through and said, not today, no more. Divine intervention wants to pop out. Free to go, karma. This backfired. They didn't realize you were protected. This was too much. Divine Feminine, you read in between the lines, with between the lines. But this Divine Master refused to see it. He could be drinking his pain. He could be in sorrow here. Very much so in regret. This masculine daydreams about reconciliation. Oop. We have fear. Didn't I tell you these people were in fear? This masculine is in fear as well. About how he could feel like these people are dangerous. For some of you Divine Feminines, this masculine is in fear. We have fear. And then we have proposal. And then we have the witches. For some of you Divine Feminines, this masculine attached himself to a witch and he's afraid. But with divine intervention being here, even this masculine is protected. So now these karmics are in fear. Divine intervention is here. So some kind of spell, some kind of something that they had to control this masculine, this has even been removed. The divine stepped in and wiped the slate clean. That's why this tower is here. Some people don't like the tower, but I love the tower. The tower is when God has to step in and said, all right, I'm going to clear this all up. And hey, where they land, and it's going to land with justice. That's for sure. And now these people are in fear. What else? Whoop. We have ghosted and cold as ice. Yeah, this, didn't I tell you, Divine Feminine, this masculine is avoiding these people? For some of you guys, this Divine Masculine could have proposed or discussed marriage with this karmic energy, but now this has blown up, or this is a karmic soul tie that has blown up with proposal and storm warning. This masculine could be getting ready to ghost this person. He's definitely ghosting his karmic friends. We have legal matters in reverse. Yeah, this masculine is, there's karmic justice here. This legal matters card also talks about justice here. Storm warning, legal matters in reverse, jack of all trades, I feel, and butterfly effect. I feel like there's karmic justice hitting all across the board. With infighting, physical fighting here, illnesses manifesting and endings all over the place. Okay. Whoever this King of Swords energy is, this karmic King of Swords energy, this person who's married or has a long-term lover who's in that Queen of Swords energy, these people are having a separation. Now there's endings in these karmics' life. Everything's falling apart. Yep, and we have home. We have home and regret. Somebody could be losing a home here. This masculine regrets an attachment. We have regret, wedding, and a toxic relationship. This is a masculine who realizes that he put himself, attached himself, could have married a karmic or got very serious with one. And now he regrets it. Child, this reading was something else. Okay, you guys? And it's long. Okay, you guys, so look, we're going to get to the extended reading. In the extended reading, okay, I am going to actually take this regret, wedding, and toxic relationship card. And I am going to clarify these cards. I'm going to read them out to see what else is here, because I feel like there's more here. Okay, you guys, so that'll be in the extended reading. Okay, we'll go through also what this masculine's next moves are towards divine feminine, what the advice is for divine feminine. But let's see what zodiac signs are involved here. We have Virgo. If you're interested in the extended reading, all the information you need to know about the extended reading is in the description box below. We have Gemini. We have Leo. I don't know why I need to pull 8 today. Okay, this could be your sign, divine feminine, divine masculine sign, or the karmic sign. Sun, moon, rising, Venus, north, nude. Okay, we have Scorpio. Let's see what else. Aquarius. Sagittarius. Cancer, and Cancer being wanting to come out. Let's do one more. Whoop. I'm gonna take the one that's at the top of this. Pisces. Okay, you guys, so there could be a Virgo, Aquarius, Gemini, Sagittarius, Leo, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. That my ear just started itching. So Pisces, I'm definitely feeling you a lot, okay? Like ringing. Okay, so there could be a Virgo, Aquarius, Gemini, Sagittarius, Leo, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, North Node, Seventh House placement. There is a lot of cusp energy here, so there could definitely be some cuspers here. You have Aquarius, Pisces, you have Gemini, Cancer, you have I think Leo, Virgo as well. So that lets me know that some of you could just be cuspers. You don't have to be those cuss signs, but I feel like a lot of you are cuspers, now that I think about it. Okay, you guys, so anyways, everything you need to know about the extended reading is in the description box below. Okay, make sure you hit the thumbs up. Let me know what you think. Okay, you guys, premium members, as usual, you get free access to all my extended readings. Non-premium members, you have a link there so you can get the extended reading. And if you're interested in becoming a premium member, check out the browse for my extended readings, for my memberships. Ugh, I'm jumbo. Jumbled up. Jumbo. I don't know. Why did I say jumbo? Okay. Somebody could be, I don't know why. I just heard big trouble. Somebody could be in big trouble. Okay. So, guys, anyways, I'll catch you on the next one. Bye.